Alhamdulillah. We thank our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala for having gathered us here in one of his houses. And our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that ما جلس قوم في بيت من بيوت الله, that no people will gather in one of the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَتْلُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَيَتَدَارَسُونَ بَيْنُهُمْ, reciting the book of Allah and studying among themselves, إِلَّا, except that نَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمَ السَّكِينَةِ, that tranquility will descend down upon them, وَحَفَّتْهُمَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, and that they will be encircled by the angels, وَغَشِيَتْهُمَ الرَّحْمَةِ, and they will be uncovered in mercy, وَذَكَرَمَهُمَ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهُ, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention them to those that are in his presence. And if we look at this last statement of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he will mention them to those that are in his presence, this is teaching us to be people of high spiritual aspiration, to move beyond merely the material realm that all of us are seeing and witnessing, to be wanting to be mentioned in the divine presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is nothing greater than to be mentioned and beloved to our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why we see that in other statements of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he taught us to have this similar meaning. When any one of us eats at one of our friend's house or anyone's house some type of food, dinner or lunch, that what is the dua that we say at the end of that? We say, أَكَلَ تَعَامُكُمْ الْأَبْرَارِ, that the righteous have eaten your food. وَصَلَّتْ عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَلَائِكَ الْأَخْيَارِ, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala subjugate to you the righteous angels. وَذَكَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهُ, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention you to those in his presence. Likewise, we see in another hadith that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that مَنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي نَفْسِي ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي نَفْسِي, that whoever mentions me alone in and of himself, I will mention him in my presence. وَمَنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَأٍ, and whoever mentions me in a group, ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي مَلَأٍ خَيْرٌ مِنْهُ, that I will mention him in a group much better than that. Teaching us is that we need to be able to look our inner sight to desire what is truly worth of desiring, because every single human being on the face of the earth has a desire, that we all have an aspiration. But our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِكُلِّن وِجْهَةٌ هُوَ مُوَلِّيهَا, that everyone has a direction, that we all have an outward orientation and we have a spiritual orientation. And from the wisdom of our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he has made every single Muslim upon the face of this earth, when they stand up to pray the five daily prayers, to face the Kaaba, to face the Kaaba and Musharrafa, so that there is this union that takes place from all the Muslims on a worldwide scale. But just as we need outward, and just as we need outward spiritual direction and orientation, we also need inward spiritual orientation. And once we realize that if we can orient ourselves inwardly and truly realize what deserves to be desired, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring great good and sweet breezes of mercy will come to their heart. And if we look at the other hadith that our Prophet said and related to this, إِنَّ لِرَبِّكُمْ فِي أَيَّامِ دَهْرِكُمْ نَفَحَاتِ, indeed your Lord has in the days of your time sweet breezes of mercy. أَلَّا فَتَعْرَدُوا لَهَا, so expose yourself to them. So to the extent that we become outwardly, internally, spiritually and physically oriented, will be to the extent that we receive these sweet mercies of our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the affair that is upon all of us and before us, because our Lord told us that our Prophet told us that إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ مَعَلِي الْأُمُورِ, that Allah ta'ala loves the highest of affairs. وَيَكْرَهُ سَفْسَافَهَا, and he dislikes low things. And مَهْمَا كَانْ, as long as someone is their spiritual aspiration is constricted to this worldly life, that this person is considered to be of low spiritual aspiration. But the true and the higher levels of spiritual aspiration are related to what goes on, because anything that is connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and done for his sake, this will go on and this will continue. Any type of companionship, anything that we do that is not done for the sake of Allah, that we will see that from the mercy of Allah, that it will be cut off in this world to teach us a lesson, so that we can learn that once we connect ourselves to the Baqi, the one who is everlasting, that in order for us to receive the true fruit of whatever it is that we are doing, that we have to do it for the Baqi, for the everlasting subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we're in this day and age, that 1400 years after our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came, that we have to realize the greatness of this teaching that we've been given. The ummah of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, they are the last repositories of sacred knowledge. That every other way to our to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been cut off. It is only through our messenger, it is only through this revelation that came to that noble heart of his that we are sitting here today and we're able to discuss that which we are discussing. And if we think about the grandiose nature of this affair, the fact that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a means for us to know the divine will, the fact that he received this revelation and then translated it to us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that we can understand something, even a small portion of his greatness. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله, that were we to have revealed this Quran to a mountain, which is one of the greatest manifestations outwardly of the power of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. What would we have seen? La ra'aytu khashi'an mutasaddian. You would have seen it fearful and split asunder. But we realize that our Prophet ﷺ, his heart being stronger than a mountain, received and bore this revelation. Despite the fact that it had an effect on him sometimes when he was with Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq and he'd be on a camel, that the camel would kneel down. Other times when Sayyidina Abu Bakr, when he would be laying on Sayyidina Abu Bakr's leg, that likewise it would kneel down. All of this is indicating the greatness and the grandiose nature of this effect. So نُلْقِي عَلَيْكَ قَوْلٍ ثَقِيلًا, that we are going to cast upon you a heavy word. And so the Book of Allah and the meanings that our Prophet ﷺ told us, this is what he left behind from his inheritance. This is what he left behind, and it is upon every Muslim to realize the importance of this inheritance so they can realize the true and be felicitous in this world and the next. And in conclusion, that this gathering that we're in, that this is an opportunity for us, that if we realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the doors of His mercy are wide open, if you realize that we are sitting before the Ghani, the one who is absolutely independent, and at the same time He is al-Mughni, He is the one that enriches, that there is nothing between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except for you to ask. There's nothing between you and attaining the highest levels of ranks except that you desire them. There's nothing between you and drawing near to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala except your own self. And once we realize that Allah Ta'ala says in Surah Al-Waqi'ah about the Muqarribeen and the Sabiqeen, those that are near to Allah and the foremost, that He says about them that they're thullutu min al-awwaleen, that there's many of them in the previous times, but they're qaleenu min al-akhireen, that there's a few of them from the later times, but He didn't say that there's none of them from the later times. That in every single time, from the time that our Prophet ﷺ left his ummah until this day now and until the end of time, that there always be among this face of this earth true inheritors of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. They're embodying the true nature of his teachings, that are means for them to draw near to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, to rid themselves of all of the dhulumat and all of the different types of shadows and darkness that is trying to prevent them from getting close to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and taking him to that light. And the people that are attain this light, وَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتٍ فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعْلَنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about this individual that was dead. Dead from the lack of knowledge and dead from the lack of faith. And when He brought him back to life, and he walks with this light among people. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala used the particle fi, which indicates is that light that is in the heart of that individual who has been brought to life and who is enlightened at the heart level, that will flow to the other hearts that are with them. And if we see on an outward level, that if this can happen even with modern communications and technology, then even more so with those that are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah ta'ala bless us to realize the greatness of the situation we're all in, to appreciate His blessings subhanahu wa ta'ala, and realize the greatness of what he revealed to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wasallam. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin wa lafu.